And so wait, that's how to render something in Arnold with a wireframe? So I'm gonna demonstrate this real quickly, and I'm recording this so I can show it to them, because I don't think they're watching right now. So I'm just gonna go load up a model so we can have something to look at. So I'm gonna go into Windows, General Editors, Content Browser, and which one should I pick? What animal should I pick here?
Dinosaur.
Dinosaur.
I heard teeth, okay.
Two people said dinosaur, one person said teeth. I was like, oh yeah, it's a teeth.
To be fair, I do too much with dinosaurs, so I'm trying to change it up a bit.
And I knew that, that's why I said it, sir.
You know me. Alright, so we got teeth, right? And they're wanting to render this with wireframe, meaning you get so you can see the polygons in the render. Alright, so let's just go launch up our Arnold renderer. So I just hit last button there on the Arnold shelf, and it starts trying to calculate it. And we see nothing, because in order to render an Arnold, you do need to have some kind of lighting. So let's go in the Arnold tab here, and I'm just going to add a sky dome light. Okay. Alright, so now we have this dome all around us that's emitting light. So whenever we go back to our Arnold render view, which I accidentally minimized, there we are. So it's got our teeth rendered, right? Now this is not a nice lighting setup or anything, so it doesn't look that great. But to do a quick wireframe, all you need to do is go up here into your Arnold render view. And there is several ways to set this up, but this is the fastest way. Go down to render, debug shading, and we're going to go to wireframe. Okay, boom. So now Arnold instantly is going to render with that AOV pass. And what we can do is just dock our Arnold view up here, kind of pull that over. Okay, so we can get a good look at this. And now in the viewport, I can kind of zoom around, and it continues to show that wireframe in real time. All right. That's all there is to it. Real quickly on the subject, there's other passes you can access. So instead of just wireframe, we could also look at occlusion. So that, so you're just seeing where ambient occlusion is being applied, which is kind of shadow area. All right, we can also look at the normals, which is assigning a color to which direction the surfaces are facing. So go ahead and look at that, you can see. So those are probably the most useful ones. There's a bunch of other ones in here. Lighting will just give you a look at what your current lighting setup is. There's also some interesting ones like UV space. So one cool thing also about the Arnold render view is you can save out an image from here very easily. So let's say you wanted to get it right about there. In the bottom right corner, there's a little camera icon. I can click that, and it's instantly kind of taking a snapshot of my render view, right? Now I can select that image, and I can save it out. So I can save image. And we can call this like UVT, right? So it is. Save that out to the desktop. And I'm going to call that. Okay, so now we actually have a file saved out of that render. So that's a real quick way to just get a render. I'm going to show what you're working on. Click off of that. That's it. So that's how to do some different render types in Arnold. I'll go back into my, don't forget to go back to debug shading and go to disable, so you can just get back to the normal window. That's it.